90. He is still unstoppable. It's a Saturday, but the founder of SGV, the country's top professional services firm, is already behind his office desk at 8 in the morning. Washington Sycip is still very much a man in a hurry. He is as motivated as the young man that stepped off a boat in 1945 to carve his future in war-ravaged Manila. Sycip retired from SGV 15 years ago at the age of 75, but he is as busy as ever. He sits on the board of more than 20 of the country's top firms, his counsel valued by the country's leading businessmen. Sycip is instrumental in bringing in many of the biggest foreign investments in the country, like the recently inaugurated Airbus 380 maintenance hangar of Lufthansa Technique Philippines, only the fourth of its kind in the world. He also spends one-third of the year traveling abroad. In his biography, Sycip humbly calls himself only a bookkeeper, but he is a respected voice for Asia in global finance. And Wash, as he is fondly called, is the ambassador and top cheerleader of the Philippine business community.
I still have to take 6-7 trips a year to the U.S. and another 6-7 trips to China, and additional trips to the region.
Can you travel alone?
Yeah.
Is that correct?
With a trolley.
Really?
Because if you travel with somebody, it increases your cost, no?
You can well afford it.
No. But it's a case where, you know, you can move faster. If you are alone, you just a trolley. And the trolley has wheels, so. But, you know, if you are enjoying what you are doing, many things are possible.
The travels are important to keep abreast of developments globally for the corporations that depend on his advice.
The reason why many of the meetings I attend, I cannot send somebody, because it's you are invited to attend these meetings. Huh? And let's say 2008, I came back from a meeting in Aspen, Colorado. And this is a meeting of about 45 people. And you have the president of the World Bank will be there, IMF people, all these top people worldwide. When I came back, I listened to what many of the comments are, then I read a lot. And I came to the conclusion that Lehman Brothers will collapse. So when I came back here, I went to see the three biggest banks here separately, and also the stock exchange and the central bank governor. And I said, I hope I'm wrong, but I'm sure I'm right. 2.5 weeks later, Lehman collapsed. But at least I gave them a 2.5 weeks benefit of as to whether they did anything, that's up to them. I don't follow that up. But they greatly appreciate the fact that that they had this piece of information.
So your passion is solving problems? What is it? Discovering things? What is your passion?
Right now, I have to carry out many of the things I do. I must have income. And many of the companies, of course, I give them advice.
You have to make money to give it away.
That's right, exactly. After paying tax.
Yeah. But you're working to give away money.
That's right, yes.
This time, Sycip is driven by causes bigger than personal ambition. He is determined to do his share in eradicating poverty. Sycip says there is a lot of work to be done. How would you assess the Philippines? I mean, is the situation getting better? Is the environment getting better?
Right now, yes, because we have a very honest president. And that's what's needed in a country. But we were told that we are going to be number two to Japan, mainly because we had democracy and that we were a Christian nation. Now, I'm not sure that these two supposedly assets were really assets or not. There's a thing as premature democracy. No? If you're still hungry, you sell your votes. That means democracy is not functioning. And the leadership of the Catholic Church has been quite different from the leadership of Catholics in other countries. No? I mean, our overpopulation is a case in point. And maybe the leadership here was a bit narrow. So I'm not sure whether per capita income, Indonesia was supposed to have just passed us. It's a Muslim nation. Malaysia is a Muslim nation, and in fact, we were the only really Christian nation.
He is one of the country's top philanthropists. His aim is to help achieve a zero dropout rate for elementary students and to help provide the poor access to credit through microfinance. He is the country's Warren Buffett and Bill Gates combined, contributing millions to NGOs.
Let's say I've tried to analyze, because I say it's partly of my responsibility to see what I can do to help that situation. No? The first thing is education. But if you're dropping out at the first or second grade, that means you are illiterate. And if you're illiterate, 99.9% sure you will be poor. And if you are poor, you sell your votes.
Sinergia, headed by Milwida Guevara, has received 70 million pesos in assistance from Sycip. The foundation aims to improve access to education by assisting local governments, parents, and the local community.
Oh, so he really devotes his resources. He was the first one who gave us our first 10 million, and he generates a lot of contribution from his friends because he sells the program to all his friends. He conscientizes them. He constantly advocates that they should support basic education. Well, his greatest gift to Sinergia is not just resources. His greatest gift is his time and his presence.
The CART Bank, or Center for Agriculture and Rural Development, founded by Dr. Aris Alip, is the country's largest microfinance institution.
He lent his reputation to us, and I think that was very important when he came in helping us way back in 2004, 2005. And because he also was one of the first high-level individual who deposited savings in CART Bank. And I felt that was very crucial.
Both Guevara and Alex say the assistance from Sycip has come quietly and without fanfare.
Well, he's considered as one of the foremost philanthropist in Asia. But the biggest difference with between him and the other Filipino donors is that Mr. Sycip has a vision, and therefore he tries to drive programs towards that vision. Kasi yung he's a very hands-on person eh. I think the other donors would just give, right? And probably they have a manager who manages the program. See, Mr. Sycip really manages our programs. So he just inspires us, but he actually tells us where should we go. So his humility is something that everybody should aspire for. He's so soft-spoken. He comes here without even a bodyguard. He refuses to be helped. He just sits down at the back.
He never want to make known of his contribution. In fact, when he give assistance or financial investment or referrals, he doesn't want his name to be mentioned. You know, so I feel he's doing it out, coming from his heart. So in terms of comparison, for me, he's beyond compare.
When People returns, the young Washington Sycip's secret job in World War II.
It was very secretive. So while the squadron was part of the Air Force, had a lot of the teletype operators who listened to the messages, and they were in numbers.